Automobiles are part of our everyday life. For some, they are only a means of getting from point A to point B. For others, they are a lifestyle. One of those groups is the classic car culture. These individuals find and rebuild classic automobiles, bringing them back from the dead to their original state or customizing them into unique pieces of art. For some, hot rod building is a hobby. For others, it's a means of income. Like Roger Ward, he has been building cars for over 60 years and making a living off of it for most of his life.
I'd rather see something that I thought was a pretty neat body style or some year I was looking for. And when I see it, it's already done. And then I've dragged that thing home, beat myself up for 2 years. It looks exactly like I thought it would, you know. And says I think for a lot of people that built them, because I built my first one like that, and everybody thought I was nuts. And then it made every major magazine in the country, and all of a sudden wagons are real hot, you know. I drive all these cars anyway. I drive all mine, and if some would break down on it, I can always find some young guy in some town that knows something about small block Chevys, or can work on a farm all tractor and get my stuff running. To drive, because that's really the fun part. If you build one and put it in a trailer and haul all over the country, there's no conversation at a Quick Trip. If you got one of them old cars, everybody wants to talk about it. Everybody wants to know what year it is. And the older people, I dated my wife in a car just like that, you know. Well, that's the cool part. And little kids go by you, they all got to look at you. You might as well be Santa Claus to them. But if you put it inside a box, man, a white box and haul across the country, yeah, you're not going to get it dirty, but you're going to miss the whole part of the fun thing.
Dean Willer is another car builder, but unlike Roger, he does not sell any of his automobiles. Once he has completed a car, it is stored in a shop along with all the others.
And I've built 27 of them in 32 years. Retired when I was 52 years old. 15 cars collected by the time I retired. So I was able to buy the building, and boy, I just went right on about November. And by June the 1st, I got my car done. And that's about time the show starts. So I take that one out, show it around about five different shows locally. And then, of course, the next year I got a different one. So they only get to show one time.
These individuals continue to create and preserve these timeless machines, keeping them on the road, representing Americana, and expressing themselves through their cars.